Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss application of radioisotopes in medicine along with NEET PG MCQs. To download lecture notes and other interesting stuff related to biochemistry, please visit website biochemistrybasics.com. Before going in the detail of radioisotopes, first let's see type of the questions that can be asked from this particular topic in theory exam. So the short notes are brief answers like therapeutic and diagnostic applications of radioisotopes and radiation hazards. Atom is the smallest unit of an element having all the properties of that particular element. An atom consists of protons, neutrons, and electrons. Protons and neutrons are present in the nucleus while electron is present on the outer orbit. So this is the atom which consists of proton, neutron and electron. Atomic number is the number of protons in an atom and mass number is the number of protons plus neutrons because the weight of electron is so small that it is negligible. Now we will see definition of isotope and radioisotope. So isotope is defined as an element with same atomic number but different atomic weight. And radioactive isotope or radioisotope therefore would behave in the same way both chemically and metabolically as the stable element with the additional advantage of giving out radiations which can be detected or can be used to destroy the tissue. Now radiation. So radiation from the atoms and its nucleus may be either particle or electromagnetic in nature. Particulate radiation consists of matter like electron, positron, proton and neutron. Electromagnetic radiation is characterized by its energy. Commonly occurring radioactivity are alpha, beta and gamma rays. And X-rays and gamma rays have the highest energy levels. Now we will see properties of radioisotope and the first property is penetrating ability. So radiation given out can travel through or penetrate the matter. Alpha particles have very poor penetrability and beta particles can penetrate only few, that is 4 to 5 millimeters in the soft tissue. And gamma rays however can penetrate deeper into the tissues and have greater penetrating power. This is the picture showing the penetrating power of different type of radiation. As discussed, alpha rays have very poor penetrating ability, beta rays have a moderate, gamma rays have a greater penetrating power and neutron have a greatest penetrating ability. So that is the penetrating power of different type of radiation. Radioactive decay. So unlike the ordinary therapeutic drugs, radioisotopes do not have an expiry date, but they are continuously losing their activity. The time taken for reduction of the activity to half of its 0 hour value is known as a physical half-life of that isotope. And the time taken by the element to reduce its body concentration to half of that administered is known as the biological half-life. So that is about physical half-life and biological half-life of radioisotope. Now ionization. So ionization is mainly responsible for the biological effects of radiation and it forms the basis for the measurement of radioactivity with detectors. Now we will discuss unit of radioactivity. So the unit of radioactivity is based not on the mass of the element but on the rate of disintegrations per second. And the unit is becquerel. It is the quantity of radioactive material in which one nuclear disintegration occurs in 1 second. The curie was formerly used as the unit of activity. The one curie is equal to 3.7 multiplied by 10 raised to 10 BQ. In order to express the radiation effect on the tissues, Units like Röntgen or more commonly rad are used. Rad expresses the dosage to the tissue in terms of energy dissipated, and 1 rad is equal to 100 erg of energy absorbed per 1 gram of tissue. So that is about the unit of radioactivity. Now we will see use of radioisotopes in medicine. So first one is therapeutic application of radioisotopes. So when radioisotopes are focused carefully on the malignant tissue, that death of the tumor cell is caused mainly due to the direct ionization effect on its DNA. The radiation also acts indirectly by creating free radicals that attack the DNA of the tumor cell, but the process is very slow. The gamma rays of cobalt are used to treat the cancer of the cervix and many other types of internal cancer. Radiophosphorus is used for the treatment of polycythemia and chronic myeloid leukemia. Radiocesium is used in the treatment of chronic leukemia. Radioiodine is used for the treatment of thyroid cancer and thyrotoxicosis. And the phosphorus is used in the dermatology for the treatment of squamous cell carcinoma. So that is the therapeutic applications of various radioisotopes. Now, diagnostic applications of radioisotopes. So radioisotopes can be used in the diagnosis of many diseases. For example, thyroid disorders can be diagnosed with radioiodine. Sodium and chromium have been used in the determination of blood volume and circulation time. Phosphorus is used for the diagnosis of cancer of liver, bone, lymph nodes and spleen. Positron emission tomography, that is PET scan. So this is the picture of PET scan. And PET scan is more precise and sophisticated technique. The isotope is produced on the spot by cyclotron. And the emission of positrons and their combination with an electron resulting in the simultaneous emission of 2 gamma rays is detected by PET camera. So that is about PET scan. Now we will see radiation hazards. Biological effects of radiation may be divided into 2 groups. First one is somatic effect, and somatic effect is divided into 2 categories. First one is the immediate effect and second one is the delayed effect. And second group is genetic effect. So first we will discuss somatic effect. The somatic radiation hazards. So in the somatic radiation hazards, first one is the immediate effect. And the immediate effect of radiation leads to acute radiation syndrome. And it is characterized by nausea, vomiting, electrolyte imbalances, fever and weakness, which is called as a gastrointestinal tract syndrome. Then acute radiation syndrome is also characterized by pancytopenia, which is characterized by reduction in RBC, WBC and platelets, and reduction in antibody production, which is known as a bone marrow syndrome. Now, delayed somatic effects. So chronic exposure to low level radiation can give rise to the certain delayed effect. And the examples are aging effect. Radiation can increase the physical processes of aging and shorten the lifespan. There is an early graying of the hair. Epilation, that is removal of hair by its roots. Early development of vascular and degenerative changes. And lenticular cataracts. So that are the aging effects. And induction of various neoplasm like carcinoma of skin following radiation, osteogenic sarcoma following radium deposition in the bones, lung cancer following the inhalation of radon in uranium mine workers, and the incidence of leukemia in children who are exposed to radiation in utero during the diagnostic radiological procedure in pregnancy. Now we will see genetic radiation hazards. We have already seen somatic hazards. Now we will see genetic radiation hazards. So So genetic effects results from injury to chromosomes that lead to various type of mutations. So that is all about radiation hazards. Now we will see radio sensitivity of various cells. So mature red cells, ganglion cells, mature connective tissue cells have a very low sensitivity towards radioactivity. Gastric mucosa, mucous membranes, esophageal epithelium and urinary bladder epithelium has an intermediate radioactive sensitivity, while primitive blood cells, intestinal epithelium, spermatozoa and lymphocytes have a very high radioactive sensitivity. So that is about the radio sensitivity of various cells. Now radiation safety and protection. So the most popular triad of radiation protection is time, distance and shield, which is also known as a TDS. So minimum possible time should be spent near the radiation zone. Handling of radioactive materials should be done from maximum possible distance, and persons should be shielded by lead. Remember, lead shielding doesn't reduce exposure by 100%. So this is the picture showing the room shielding. That is the lead lined plaster board, and that is the lead glass viewing window. And these are the picture of lead aprons. Now we will see various multiple choice questions. So becquerel is a unit of light energy, unit of radioactivity, type of radiation or measure of half-life of radioisotope. So the correct answer is B. It is a unit of radioactivity. Second question is, the most penetrating rays are alpha rays, gamma rays, beta rays and X-rays. So the correct answer is B, gamma rays. And the last question is, radioisotope used for the treatment of polycythemia is phosphorus, iodine, cobalt. So the correct answer is A, phosphorus. Phosphorus is used for the treatment of polycythemia. These are my references. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit. And don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it.